Hey guys, it's Gaba VR and welcome to this 360 comparison video. We will go step by step comparing the different video modes of Insta360 cameras in different shooting conditions. In this video I will show you different shots on an overcast and sunny day, and even indoors in low light conditions recorded in normal, log and HDR video mode. I will show you these videos straight out of the camera and after color grading and matching them as much as possible. I hope looking at these differences you can pick up your favorite settings for your scenes. If you are interested about the detailed comparison, check it out in the right top corner. First, let's see a Tesla charger scene, looking at the different objects close to the camera and in the distance on an overcast day. Now you can see the video shot manually with the normal mode. It looks nice, but looking at the clouds you can see some blown out spots where the sun shines through them. Then looking at the HDR video, you can see a little bit darker image. But also the clouds look much better without any blown out areas on the sky. But the overall look is a little bit darker than in the normal mode. And finally, this is the log video. It was shot with the same exposure settings as a normal video, but as you can see, it has slightly better dynamic range, especially in the shadows. But on the other hand, it seems to be the noisiest one straight out of the camera. Here you can see the same scene after color grading. And talking about noisiness, let me note that I didn't apply any noise reduction. While shooting with the normal mode, Insta360 possibly applies automatic noise reduction. So looking at the details, we could get a slightly sharper image shooting in log mode and applying manual noise reduction. Just look at the normal video after color grading. It's still nice, but not so detailed in the shadows, while we can see some blown out areas in the highlights. And finally, here is the HDR video, which handles the highlights very well, but the overall image is a little bit less sharp and detailed than the log video. And it's even softer around the stitch lines. But let's see all the three versions side by side mixed together. And then let's go forward to the sunny scene. Here you can see the properly exposed normal video with a basic dynamic range, with a little bit shady parts in the shadows and a burnout area around the sun. Switching to the log video shot with the same exposure, you can see much more details in the shadows, and the whole image is a little bit crispier, while of course it's a little bit undersaturated, having a washed out look. But of course we have to fix it with color grading. But until that, let's take a look at the HDR video. It has better shadows and a perfect look around the sun, but the whole image is a little bit softer and seems less detailed than the log video. And after color grading, it still looks nice. Take a look at the forest and the sun. There's quite a big dynamic range between the darkest and brightest parts of the image. But switching to the log video, you can see a more detailed and a little bit brighter shadow area in the forest, while of course we lost some details around the sun. And finally, here you can see the normal video after color correction, with a blown out sky around the sun and a shadier look in the forest. Just take a look at the mixed image in terms of sharpness and dynamic range. Shooting in low light conditions is always a challenge. Looking at the log video, we can see quite a balanced and sharp image with a lot of noise. Of course, it always depends on the ISO settings and our practical lights in the scene. You can check out my low light vlog video in the right top corner, where I was shooting at night with way better results. But such an overall dark scene like this restaurant is the worst scenario we can find for shooting. Just look at the normal shot. It's quite noisy too, but a little bit softer and darker at the shadow areas, which maybe seems better than the detailed but noisier shadows in the log video. And finally, here is the HDR version. As you can see, the image is way softer and less detailed, but we must confess it has less noise too. While the dynamic range is not better, even more you can see artifacts on the wall, and looking at the back door, it also seems weird. With color grading we can get rid of the purple shine, but without some extra sharpening, the overall image looks a little bit soft. Switching to the log video, the highlights on the wall look more natural, but of course without a proper noise reduction, the scene is really noisy. And finally, looking at the normal mode, it's quite similar to the HDR version, but it's way sharper and there are no artifacts, while it's a little bit noisier than the HDR video. Let's take a look at these videos side by side. And I hope this short comparison helps you select the best mode for your 360 camera. So if you like this video, please give a thumbs up. And for further 360 contents and tutorials, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And see you next time!